Hello, everyone. Good morning or afternoon. I don't even know what time it is. My name is Robin Waldy, and today I want to go over some contouring basics with you. I went ahead and did sort of a base face, just enough to make me look alive, and I left off my contour, which is usually about the second or third thing I do when I'm getting ready. But I went ahead and did a little bit of blush. And hi Randy, welcome. And so I'm just gonna show you what contouring can do. And so I'm gonna be using this beachfront bronzer today and just this old Bare Minerals brush that I happen to have. Another really awesome brush for contouring is this magic wand, as I call it, which I use to put my foundation and my concealer on with. This is by Unique and it is called Powder Concealer Brush. I love it because of the dual ends, but because I do use it for my foundation and my concealer, I don't really want to get the dark color on here and accidentally create worse bags under my eyes than I already have, or worse circles. So I just like to use this brush. I have pretty sharp features. I like to really concentrate my contouring. Some people might want a fluffier brush like this or something, but I prefer the sharper edges so I can really get it just where I want it for my contour. So the basics about contouring is the premise that dark colors make things recede and lighter colors make things come forward, as will something that has a shine to it or any kind of a luminescence. That's going to bring things forward. We all have different things on our faces that we maybe prefer weren't there, and I am no exception to this. I actually didn't ever contour before I became a makeup presenter, and then I kind of saw the beauty of it, of watching other people's videos, and decided to give it a try for myself. And now it's actually kind of hard for me to not contour, but again, I'm going to be using this beachfront bronzer for my contouring. There's a light side and a dark side. I don't know if you can see this real well, but I use the dark side so much. Like, I've actually worn a divot there. I don't do a lot of bronzing because I'm so fair. I don't really go in the sun, so I don't really feel the need to look bronzed up. But I like this darker side for my contour. So I'm just going to use the edge of my brush here. And I like to go, I don't go too far back because I already have these natural indentations that are pretty prominent on me, and I don't really want to emphasize those. So I just kind of go here where my natural line is under the apples of my cheeks, because I want to emphasize this part and make it look nice and perky again. As we get older, things start to fall. You know, what once was up here, or maybe this line used to be up here, now it's down here. You know, the jawline, which was once up here, is now down here. The chin, my chin is getting longer as I get older. So I just like to put that there. And like I said, I don't go all the way back just because I already have such an indentation. But you may, a lot of people like to take it all the way back to their ear. I'm just focusing on my natural, where my indentation would naturally fall. Hi Star, welcome. And then sometimes I actually take it up a little higher than it needs to be. And then sometimes, depending on the look I want, I'll actually bring it down a little bit lower than it needs to be, just to really create that recess. And don't worry with how it looks, because once it's blended out, it's all gonna look very natural. I also am developing these little points here, these little jowls, where my jawline is not so prominent anymore. What once looked like that, now it looks like this. Hey, it happens. Aging is a blessing, right? So I'm just gonna put a little bit of this darkness. Think of this as another sort of magic wand that just makes those things disappear. I mean, it doesn't really make it disappear. It's not magic, but it can fool the eye. So I'm just putting that right on those spots and where I want to emphasize my jawline. But because I have such a recess here, I don't put the dark color here because I don't want to emphasize that right there. And then I just do my chin, just the bottom, just trying to give the illusion that it's not as long and as it is, and hoping that leaving this alone will actually kind of make this look a little bit more continuous and not emphasize these marionette lines that I'm getting quite as much. Of course, you always want to continue that color down here. You don't want to forget about the underneath, because other people see you from the side. They're not always looking at you straight on like you're looking at yourself in a mirror. So you want to make sure that you're just bringing that color down a little bit, and it's all about creating shadows. So I want to create that shadow underneath and bring it down. You don't want it to look so dark that it's ridiculous, but you're going to blend. The key to everything is blend, blend, blend. When in doubt, blend it out. Okay, my forehead is also tall, and try as I may, I have a lot of bangs right now, but it's just so natural for me to put my bangs back and just to have stragglers hanging down. So I generally will contour the top part of my forehead. Again, darker colors make things recede. Also just adds a little bit of color. So it just adds balance to your whole face, because it's all about creating balance too. And again, once this is blended out, it won't look so scary. Some people prefer a cream bronzer, a cream contour. We actually have a contour stick too, which I have right here. These were on sale. I think we still have them actually. I don't know. There were some items that were being discontinued. But this is a dual-ended. You have your contour on one end and your highlight on the other. So some people prefer a cream. I just go with the powder. So the next thing I want to contour is my nose. My nose is already on the slender side, but my nose is pretty darn crooked. You may not notice it in my videos because I usually have my camera actually a little bit to this side of me because this is my better side. I'm gonna turn, I don't really like to show people this, but can you see?